Alrighty, folks, so here we are. We are back with Factorio C-Block. Last episode, we put down the blueprints for the electrolyzers and for the liquidizers. And the eagle-eyed among you will notice that this is not the same configuration that I laid down in the blueprint. And in hooking this up, one of the things I decided to do is move these to the other side and take advantage of the longer reach on the inserters and the fact that we can pluck off of the backside of our undergrounds in order to kind of make this a little easier to connect and a little, you know, a little less of a problem. So we got that done up there, and we did the same thing down here. So this is all hooked up. So we are kind of ready to start building out our fuel supply and our power supply. Now, the other thing we were talking about is we've been talking about the Spidertron, and we discovered there are a couple of things that we did not have for the Spidertron, and we had to research one of them and what have you. So while we're doing that, I went ahead and set this up so that I know what I need to do to make the Spidertron. And one of the things we need is rubberized wire, and we're not making rubber. So we are making the pulp, we are making the seeds and the trees, but we're not making this portion of it. So we need to make acetone from the pulp, and we need to make liquid rubber from the trees, and then combine the two of them. That's going to give us rubber. All right, so we got to get that done. Next thing I realized, we're making small poles, but we're not making medium poles, and we're not making large poles. So we need to start doing that. And then we need CPUs to make the Spidertron, and that was the research we did not have. And it's going to be a little complex to build these. Nothing we can't do. So we're going to have to add this process here, which is some kind of nitrosilicone or something like that. So we got to put in nitrogen gas, and we got to put silicone together. And that's going to make this powder stuff that's going to go in here. On the other side, we need platinum wire. And we're not making platinum. And so I started to look at the process to make platinum. And it's a little convoluted. Ultimately, it comes from a couple of ores that we're already able to make. And we'll just have to make them, crush them down, combine them with certain other stuff, and that's going to turn around and give us the stuff that we need to make the ore we need. Now, we are going to need to make one other type of ore, but we're not going to, probably not going to make this in the large quantities that we're making everything else. I don't see a whole lot of call for this yet. At some point, these CPUs, we're going to have to use them for a lot of other things, so we will have to expand this, but not right now. Mainly, we want a Spidertron. So we're going to work towards that. And then I got to thinking, okay, well, while we're doing this, let's look at what it's going to take to make Yellow Science. And this right here is what it's going to take for us to make Yellow Science. Minus the things we're already making. So the things we're already making is our exterior inputs. All the rest of this stuff we are going to have to do to make Yellow Science. And it's going to give us, for all of this, every time we flip this once, it's going to give us two. So this is, we're getting ugly here, guys. We're starting to get real kind of ugly on the complexities, but hey, that's Factorio, right? So that's where we're headed. But before we do that, I decided to do something that some people are going to probably say, well, that's kind of stupid. Other people are going to say, well, you're crazy, you're nuts. I tend to lean towards the yup, I'm nuts part. And what we're going to do is, I went up here, we're almost done filling this in, but I took a break on that because I wanted to fill this part in so we could get one more railroad cell up here. And that's where we're headed. We're headed up here. The reason we're headed up here is I'm going to put in solar. We've had the ability to make it for a while. We've had the factory set up to make it for a while, but we have not been using it. We've just been relying off the steam engines. And maybe some people want to go solar. Eventually, the solar will supposedly save us on ups, but right now we're not having a problem with it. I mean, we're rocking 60 frames a second, 60 ups for the most part, but at some point that may become a problem. So why not, let's go up and set up solar. Plus, that way we can look at it. Some people would prefer solar, some people would prefer, you know, steam. We are so far from nuclear, it's not funny. We're gonna set up solar. So the other thing, let's go ahead and take a look at our tech real quick. We have three more that are just the blue tech. You know, they're military tech too, but they're just the blue tech. And then we get into the purple tech, which is really kind of slower because it takes the blue circuits. We're not really producing the blue circuits that much. In looking at this, to be perfectly honest, I mean, let's go ahead and grab these three just to get them out of our queue and to be done with the blues, with the lower levels, and get into the purples. But when I look at the purples, the majority of it is really just improvements to techs that we already have. Now, with the exception of the artillery wagon, which, I mean, we played around with the artillery, and it was fun shooting stuff, but the plasma turrets work just wonderfully, and the artillery kind of is not cost-effective, if you will. It takes out all the biters in one shot, but the islands are so small that it's really not very effective. It's better to just use the plasma turrets, in my opinion. Again, we don't have the nuclear power yet, and what have you. So there's really only a few things, like this water chemistry, and then some of the advanced materials and what have you that are of any real benefit to us. Now we're going to go ahead and we're going to take the Steel Axe 5 just to increase our mining speed, just to be able to pick up buildings faster. All right. And then the next one that I'm going to take. Oh, and of course, when we get up into the yellow, we start getting into things that are like real world kind of stuff. The RTG, the radio thermoelectric generator, they actually use those in the space program. It's actually not radio thermoelectric. It's radiographic thermoelectric generator, something like that, I think. You can look it up on the internet. Basically, they're using nuclear decay to create heat, and then they're converting that heat into electricity. That's what they use on satellites and things like that. So it's kind of cool that we're getting into some real-world stuff. So that's up in the yellow, though. We're not there yet. We're still in the purples. So I'm not going to grab the Covarex. We might grab, might grab the Puffer. You know what I do want to grab, though? Let us start becoming 1940s Germany. We're going to get water chemistry, and water chemistry is going to give us this heavy water, which, if anybody remembers their history, is like the precursor that Germany was working on for getting the nuclear bomb during World War II. So let's go research heavy water and, start building ourselves some heavy water, shall we? And then from there, I think, see, all of these are just improvements. I think we're gonna stick with the theme of improving our metals and minerals first. Now, this may screw us up in that we'll have to rebuild what we've already got. I don't know, but let's start with that, shall we? and that'll get us going, and we'll pick up the rest of these metal ones, and we'll go from there. All right, so that's got our research going. So let's go ahead and jump on our train, and let's head on up where we want to be. And I have with me a train stop, so that when we get up here, we're going to put down a train stop, because I know we're going to go back and forth a couple of times, having to get pieces parts to fill this all in. But let's run all the way up here, and I'm watching my mini map, so I know when my turn is coming up. And we're going to go up all the way to the farthest location up here, and we're going to put in a train stop. Nobody should bother us up here. It should be out of the way of all the other trains. We shouldn't have any problems with it. But we're just going to put down a train stop, and we're going to call this... let's call it solar construction. Sound good? I think that'll work. So there we go. One of the things that came up in the comments of my videos, in the past I used to put the name of the, or name the video, and then I would put, like, in the title, I would put, you know, part of what's going on, and I kind of stopped doing that on these ones, and I did it for two reasons. One was I was lazy, and two, I was kind of trying to avoid having real long video titles. I didn't want to put super long video titles up, so I didn't do it, but it was suggested that it would be helpful in searching for videos and stuff if I put, you know, like what we did in the video, like if we worked on blue science, that kind of thing, just put blue science in there. So I'm thinking about it. I'm kind of weighing it over, or, you know, weighing it in my mind. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments if you guys got any thoughts on it. So we are currently building the substations, right? Just the regular substations. We have the ability to build the substation twos. And as you can see, they have a bigger footprint, is the only real difference between the two. And I was kind of playing around with the solar panels, because now we have the larges, the mediums, and the smalls, right? And I was trying to find a pattern that was a good pattern inside of the footprint of the substations. And it's always one of those things where on the vanilla game, because you don't have the different sizes and stuff, and you don't have the different size substation solar panels, finding a good tileable pattern for the substations without holes can be problematic. So a lot of times what you end up with is you put in accumulators with them and this and that and the other. But I was trying to find a way to lay out the panels in such a way that there were no holes. And, but also in such a way that you could tile these. In other words, I didn't want the edge of the panels, excuse me, just a second, excuse me, going past the effect for the substation, right? So I was playing with how could I fill these in, you know, so that they would fill in properly. And it's a puzzle. And part of the debate I was having was it better because the substation 2s cover more ground? Was it better to use the substation 2s than the substation 1s? And some of the things that I found is, as you can see, I can't put like a one, with these ones, it's only a space out of one row. With these ones, it's a space out of two rows. Now I can finagle in some mediums here. We're going to take these out of our way. And I can finagle in some mediums, right? And then I can finagle in some smalls. And mostly fill it in, right? But I've still got like a small worth of space. And I puzzled this around and I puzzled it around. And any way I tried to do this, it really kind of, see, I can't go that way. It really did, it had wasted space. If I come over here, now, admittedly, it's going to cost me, in the long term, more substations. But I can completely fill that space in. I'm not losing a space by using the smalls and the mediums. And if you remember from the video a long, long time ago, I compared the cost, the material cost for each of these up each step, and they're equal as far as the production and what have you. So there's no real loss to using the small ones, but it does let us fill in that little bit of extra space. And from a distance, you don't really see it. Now, I could put, admittedly, I could put accumulators in there. But then I got accumulators in there, and they're not panels. So I think even though these ones are going to use less of them, because of the material difference in them, where is it? These ones use red circuits, 5 copper, 10 steel, 5 red circuits. These ones use twice that much, you know, plus it's tin wire and brass plate. I don't know that the savings is that much for the amount of space that we're going to save. Because if you look at this, really, I think it's the amount of increase is probably as much as just a couple of substations. So I don't know that it's going to add that much bang for the buck, especially when I think about the aesthetics of these holes in the middle. You know what? Why are we doing that? That's what we have flying monkeys for. So I think I'm going to use the smaller substations. I think they're going to do us the better job. Now, the next conundrum, if you will, with that was, do I completely fill this space without walkways, or do I put in walkways? so that I can get between them, down the center of them. And I got to thinking about it. And to be honest with you, if the intention is to fill this in and just have it produce power and nothing else, I'm really never going to have to come back through here. So if I just completely fill this with solar panels and accumulators, half and half-ish, I don't think it's going to matter. I don't think it's going to be that much of a problem because we don't have to go in the middle of them ever. And since it's and that was my reasoning for going way up here, is because by going way up here, I'm out of middle of nowhere. It's not some place where I'm going to have to visit. Right? So I thought, why not put them up here and just, I don't know why I didn't just pick them up, because it looks like it's going to be faster than waiting on the bots. Rather than going through all of the issues of land paths and stuff, why don't we just grid it out? Why don't we just put the whole thing as one giant solar panel and one giant accumulator? They don't wear out. We don't have to do maintenance on them. And we don't have rocks falling out of the sky like we do in space exploration. We'll get those ones when we get down there. So my thought process was to go ahead and just lay them out. Now, the other question I was asking myself was, do I put in RoboPorts? And again, once they're laid down, I don't think we need to worry about RoboPorts. It's simply a matter of getting them laid down, I think, is the first real issue. And I think I'm going to go all the way to the edge of the track. Now, we're going to lose that one corner on all four corners, but big deal, right? I think this is what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to do this. We're just going to go straight down here. Like that, right? Now, of course, now that we have that, we can go back and we can copy it. Make our life a little easier because it's now a bigger section at a time. And we'll see how far down here we can get. All right, and here we are at that other line, and we're just going to get rid of that other line. Now, I know that's going to get rid of the radars, and that's going to, you know, give us a hard time as far as being able to lay things down and see things. But we can address that after we get this laid out. I think we're getting close to the bottom here. We're also getting close to our batteries running out, and we're going to slow down on our foot speed soon. But what I want to see is how far down we can manage to go. It looks like that's it there. I mean, we could potentially go one more, but then we're wasting some of the space on the track. I don't know that it would be worth it to get that little bit of extra. And then we're going to go and we're going to see how far over we can go. Because again, we're going to go both solar and, now I could do that because it should be a square, right? Yeah, I could do that. Yep, see, and then we're too far that way. So we're going to go right there. So let's make a count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38. So half of 38 is 15 and 4, 19, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So right there is the halfway part point. Right? So then if we fill all of this in, with that being the halfway point, there's what we've got. So this is going to be all solar panels. And like I say, somebody's going to tell me I'm a crazy SOB for doing this. And yeah, they are probably right. But Are you not entertained? I mean, that's really, if you think about it, why do we play Factorio if it's not that fun? What's the point of doing it and not having fun with it? Everybody's idea of fun is a little different. This kind of farting around like this, this is my fun. I like to do things like this. All right, so that's going to be all of the substations for that. So let's go ahead and lay out what a group of solar panels would be. See, I told you we were going to run out of power, and it's nighttime, so that doesn't help either. But we're almost up where we want to be. Right, so that's going to be our four, because that's, no. No. We're doing it in threes. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Three. So we want it here. Right, so that is going to be a grid of three, or of nine. And that's what we're going to base this layout off of. Whoa, wait a minute. What is off? Something's off. Because we did this. All right, hang on. Because I just had this all figured out, guys. Hang on. Right? All right, if we're doing that one there, okay, then we're going to get rid of this row. Right, because that was that. Or did I do it in four? Oh, you know what? No. My bad. When I did the panels, I did them in fours. Not threes. I did them that way. All right, that's fine. This is what we want. Because then we want to go in here. Like that. And we'll put those ones back. But that's what we want. That's the blueprint we want right there. Because that is going to give us the one for our panels. Now we can go ahead and put this back. There we go. And then we're going to pick this up because it doesn't match up properly. Because we didn't start from the corner. There we go. All right. Now we can do what we wanted to do. Now, like I say, we're going to lose, you know, those panels there, but that's okay. If I really want to get crazy about it, I guess we could see what will fit. Huh? Or we can just leave them out. I mean, really? God, I don't want to do that. All right. What we should do to do this right is to shift the whole thing down and over a little bit. That would be the right way to do it. I don't know if I want to do that. That's what we're going to do. We're going to shift this whole thing down and over so that they fit. Because we got the room for it, right? We have that little bit of room at the bottom and a little bit of room there. I know it's stupid, but it's 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. That's where we're going to do it. We're going to base it off of that right there. Uh-oh. Don't stand in the middle of your blueprint if your blueprint is going to lock you in. There we go. Because now we can do that. Now, obviously, we're going to have to do this a little at a time. We don't have Robo Quartz. And I think there we go. I think the most we can catch at a time is half. Or not. I'm going to say, once it's built, who cares? Right. Tried to beat it. You suck. All right, so what did we say? We said 19, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. All right. Huh. We got an alien artifact we missed somewhere. What I'm going to do is we get this laid out or cleaned up or whatever you want to call it. Not completely. We're not going to do the whole thing. We're not going to lay the whole thing out as far as the solar panels, but we're going to power's out again because the sun is out or sun is gone. Oh, I think. No. So we're going to do 18 across. We're going to lay the 19th as far as the substation, but we're not going to do the panels to the 19th because that's where the split is. And then we're going to do the first row of accumulators. And then once we've got the first row of both done, that is gonna be it. And I will do the rest of it by hand off camera, or not by hand, but off camera. So let's go up here and count and make sure we've got 18. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. All right, so there's number 18. That makes that 19, right? And then that makes that 19 from the other side. And just so that we know, we'll put an accumulator there, and we will put a small panel there. So that in theory, that is the dividing line. Then we'll go over here and we'll count and make sure we did our math right. And we will make sure we did our spacing right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. There it is, 19. And if you notice, that corner lined up nicely. So now we'll check and make sure the bottom corner lines up nicely. And I don't care how many we go this way. I just want them to be lined up properly down the middle. Now, I'm not going to get super anal retentive and say it's off center by one. That would be a little too much even for me. I mean, technically I could do it because I could lay them all out, blueprint it, pick them all up, and shift them. But that would be too much even for me. That would be too me. I think I'll be happy with that right there. I think that will be just fine. So we're going to go back up here. all of the ones that need picking up will get picked up as we lay panels. What I want to see now is how that center plays out. So then, so yeah, we could do smalls down the center as a dividing line, and then if we put this back. Take up this one. Because we know that these fit the same size as the substations. So they end up being completely filled in. On a 4x4. How many is it? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there it is. There is. Oops. There is a an accumulator layout. All right, guys. So with the exception of this very last one, that's got to be kind of filled in by hand. To get the right deal with the panels. We've got it all done. Well, not done. But we know what it is we're after. We just got to get some more small panels. For the few places that we got to fill in. So there it is, guys. That's the plan. We are going to fill this with panels and accumulators. We will never have to worry about power again. In fact, it probably will end up overtaking our power plant. We can shut our power plant off. But I just wanted to lay that out to give you guys, and we're going to fill in one just to see what kind of power production we have from that. Just so you guys can kind of know. All right, so there it is, guys. I hope that wasn't too super boring. By the time we come back, that'll all be filled in, and we can get started on these changes that we need to make down here. All right, I'll talk to you later. You guys take care. Bye.